प्रॉब्लम सेट टू, फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन. चूज द करेक्ट आंसर्स फॉर द फॉलोइंग क्वेश्चंस. फर्स्ट एग्जांपल, व्हिच वन इज द क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन. द फर्स्ट ऑप्शन इज 5 upon x minus 3 इज इक्वल टू एक्स स्क्वेयर. हियर वेरिएबल इज देयर इन द डिनोमिनेटर. सिंस वी हैव टू मल्टीप्लाई ईच एंड एवरी टर्म बाई एक्स, सो वी विल गेट 5 minus 3x, दैट इज इक्वल टू एक्स क्यूब. And we have the degree 3, so it is not quadratic equations. One variable is there, but degree is not 2, that is 3, so it is not quadratic equation. And we have to get the quadratic equation. See, the option B, x into x is x square plus 5x. And if we transfer this 2 to the left side, we will get x square plus 5x minus 2 equal to 0, which is the quadratic equation. So our correct answer is option B. Now we will check option C. One variable is there, but degree is not 2, since it is not quadratic equation. Here also we have one variable, but degree is not 2. If we transfer this x square to the right side, it will become x cube. Since the variable is in the denominator, we have to transfer it to the right side, or you have to multiply both the sides by x square. So here we will get x cube. X square into x is x cube, so it is not the quadratic equation, and the correct answer is option B, x into bracket x plus 5, that is equal to 2, that is the correct option. Now second example, out of the following equations, which is not quadratic equation? Here we have asked to get the quadratic equation, and here we have asked it should not be a quadratic equation. We have given 4 options, and we have to select that option which is not the quadratic equation. So we will check the first option. Now x square plus 4x is equal to 11 plus x square. If we simplify it, x square gets cancelled. We have one variable, we have degree 2, but after simplification, x square gets cancelled, and this is not the quadratic equation. And see, we have to, out of the following equation which is not the quadratic equation, the first option, that is not the quadratic equation. We will check another options. Option B, it is quadratic equation. As variable is, one variable is there and degree is 2, it is quadratic equation. Here also variable is 1 and degree is 2, it is quadratic equation. And here also we have one variable and degree 2. Now some students thinking, why here x square not gets cancelled like here? See, these signs are different. We have minus x square here. If we transfer it to the right side, it will become plus x square, and x square plus x square becomes 2x square. That is not going to eliminate. So that is also a quadratic equation. So our correct answer is option A, which is not the quadratic equation. So here we will write option A, x square plus 4x, that is equal to 11 plus x square. It is not the quadratic equation. Now here we have third example. The roots of x square plus kx plus k is equal to 0 are real and equal. Find k. We have given a quadratic equation. It is given that the roots of the given quadratic equation are real and equal. So find k. And we know that when the roots of the given quadratic equation are real and equal, if and only if delta is equal to 0, that is b square minus 4ac is equal to 0. Since we write here b square minus 4ac, it is equal to 0. Why? Because the given quadratic equation has real and equal roots. Therefore, we write b square minus 4ac equal to 0. This part we no need to write into the answer sheet. We have to write that part on the rough page to make the calculation. So here we will get the values of a, b and c. Value of a is 1. Value of b is k, and value of c is also k. So we will put these values here. Value of b is k, square of it minus 4 into 1 into k, that is equal to 0. Now simplify this, k square minus 4k equal to 0. We will take k as common, so inside the bracket k minus 4 is remaining. And now we have the product of these two factors 0. It means that either k is equal to 0 or k minus 4 is equal to 0. And we have k is equal to 0 or k is equal to 4. Since the correct answer is option C, 0 or 4. So here we will write our answer, option C, that is 0 or 4. And now example number 4. For root 2 into x square minus 5x plus root 2 is equal to 0, find the value of discriminant. We have to find the value of the discriminant for this given quadratic equation, and already the given quadratic equation is into the standard form. So, directly getting the values of a, b and c, we will find the value of discriminant, that is b square minus 4ac. So, here we have to find the value of b square minus 4ac, since we will write here b square minus 4ac is equal to. Now, put the values there, value of b is minus 5, minus 4 multiplied by minus 4 multiplied by value of a is root 2 and value of c is also root 2. Is root 2 into root 2. So, square of any negative number is always positive, minus is root 2 into root 2 is 2, and 2 into 4 is 8, and 25 minus 8 is 17. So, correct answer is option B. Here we will write option B, 17. That is the value of discriminant. We have 4 more examples. Example number 5, 6, 7 and 8 in the first question. 4 examples gets completed, we will take 4 more examples. Example number 5 from first question. Which of the following quadratic equation has roots 3, 5? We have to get the quadratic equation having roots 3, 5. And we know that when we have given the roots of the quadratic equation, how to get the required quadratic equation. Here we have given the values of alpha and beta. That is, alpha is equal to 3 and we have beta is equal to 5, and we have to get the quadratic equation. So, first we will get alpha plus beta, that is 3 plus 5, it is equal to 8. Then we will get alpha into beta, that is 3 into 5, it is equal to 15. And now we know the required quadratic equation, that is x square minus x into bracket alpha plus beta bracket close plus alpha into beta equal to 0. Put the values there, x square minus x multiplied by 5, sorry, alpha plus beta is 8 plus alpha into beta is 15, and this is the required quadratic equation, x square minus 8x plus 15 is equal to 0. Now check the option, which one is the correct option? X square minus 8x plus 15 is equal to 0, that is option B. So, here we will write the answer option B, that is x square minus 8x plus 15 equal to 0, that is the correct answer. Now, we have example number 6. In this example, out of the following equation, find the equation having sum of the roots minus 5. We have to get the quadratic equation having sum of the roots minus 5, means alpha plus beta is equal to minus 5. We have to find the equation out of these 4 equations, which equation is the equation for which alpha plus beta is minus 5, that is sum of the roots for this given quadratic equation is minus 5. So, just we have to check for which equation alpha plus beta is equal to minus 5. Now, here given equation, given quadratic equation is into the standard form, and we have to get the value of alpha plus beta, and if that value alpha plus beta get minus 5, then this is our answer. If for this quadratic equation we get minus 5, so this is the correct answer, this is the correct option for us. For this quadratic equation, if we get alpha plus beta is equal to minus 5, then this is the correct equation, or the equation for which the alpha plus beta is minus 5. And here also we have to check. Now, for which equation we will get alpha plus beta minus 5? Some students directly checking here, see x square means we know the required quadratic equation when the roots are given, that is x square minus x into bracket alpha plus beta plus alpha into beta is equal to 0. And some students thinking this may be the correct answer, but this is not the correct answer. X square minus x into the bracket sum of the roots, x square minus, this minus is from the required quadratic equation, that is from the formula, and we have alpha plus beta 5 and we need minus 5. So don't think like that. We will get the value of alpha plus beta for each and every quadratic equation, because this is very important question, as this is multiple choice question. But if we select the wrong option, then we are getting one mark less there. So we have to think carefully about that thing, and we have to get the appropriate answer. So we'll see this by heart. It is not necessary to make each and every calculation there. Minus b upon a, here minus b, the value of b is minus 15, minus of minus, that is plus 15, upon value of a, that is 3, and 3 5 is 15. We get sum of the roots 5, but we need minus 5 for this equation. We have to get the value of minus b upon a. See, minus from the formula, that is minus b upon a, minus of minus 5, that is plus 5, upon a is 1. Again we are getting plus 5 here. So this is also not the quadratic equation which we required. So here we come, minus b upon a, see, minus value of b is 3 upon a, that is 1. We get minus 3, value of alpha plus beta minus 3, and this is not the required quadratic equation. Now here, this is minus into the formula, from the formula, minus value of b is 15 upon 3, minus 15 upon 3 is minus 5. So this is the correct option, in which for this quadratic equation we have alpha plus beta equal to minus 5, or sum of the roots of this quadratic equation is minus 5. We can check here, alpha plus beta is equal to minus b upon a for this equation only. Now sum of the roots is equal to minus b upon a, minus sign remains as it is, value of b is 15 divided by value of a is 3, and we have minus 5, that is sum of the roots is minus 5. For this quadratic equation we have sum of the roots minus 5. So correct answer is option D, that is 3x square plus 15x plus 3 is equal to 0. We can use this value for each and every quadratic equation. We will write that value. See, for the first quadratic equation, always we have to write, we have to get the sum of the roots. So here you can write sum of the roots, that is alpha plus beta is equal to minus b upon a. For the first quadratic equation, minus 15, value of b, minus 15 upon a is 3, minus of minus is plus 15 upon 3, that is 5. We have to get it minus 5, but we get plus 5. So this is not the required quadratic equation. Now we will check for the second quadratic equation here. Sum of the roots is equal to minus b upon a. For this quadratic equation, this minus sign remains as it is, value of b is minus 5 upon value of a is 1. And this is again equal to plus 5, and we need minus 5. Sum of the roots should be minus 5, and we get plus 5. So this is not the required quadratic equation. Now for this quadratic equation, we have sum of roots is equal to minus b upon a, minus sign as it is, value of b is 3 divided by value of a is 1, it is equal to minus 3, and we need minus 5. So this is also not the required quadratic equation. So definitely this is the required quadratic equation, and we already check the sum of the roots for this quadratic equation, we get 5. So the correct answer is option D, that is 3x square plus 15x plus 3 is equal to 0. Now example number 7, root 5 into m square minus root 5 into m plus root 5, that is equal to 0. Which of the following statement is true for this equation? See the options, the roots are real and unequal, the roots are real and equal, roots are not real, and option D is 3 roots. We know the quadratic equation has only 2 roots, so this option is incorrect. We have 3 options, and out of the 3, which one is correct? So we have to get the value of b square minus 4ac. From that value we can determine, see, these all the 3 options are the nature of the roots of the quadratic equation, and we have to decide nature of the roots of the quadratic equation by using the value of b square minus 4ac. Since we write here b square minus 4ac, it is equal to value of b,
that is negative root 5
square of it minus 4 into
value of a root 5 and value of c root 5.
This is root 5 into root 5. So square of any negative number is always positive, and square root of 5, square of the square root of 5 is 5. Minus sign remains as it is, root 5 into root 5, 5, 5 for the 20. This 5 minus 20 is minus 15.
B square minus 4ac is equal to minus 15. And we know that if delta is less than 0, if delta is less than 0, the roots of the given quadratic equation are not the real numbers. When delta is less than 0, at that time roots of the given quadratic equation are not the real number. So, our correct option is option C, roots are not real. Roots are not real. Why? Because we get the value of discriminant, that is b square minus 4ac, and it is less than 0. If it is greater than 0, then the roots are real and unequal, and if it is equal to 0, then the roots are real and equal. So, we get delta is less than 0 since our answer is roots are not the real numbers. And now, last example from the first question, that is example number 8. One of the roots of the equation x square plus mx minus 5 is equal to 0 is to find m. We have given one root of this quadratic equation, x square plus mx minus 5 is equal to 0. This is the given quadratic equation, and we also given that one root of this quadratic equation means one value of the variable x is 2. Out of the two roots, one root is 2, then find m means we have to put 2 in place of x, because see, this 2 is the root of the given quadratic equation, means one of the value of the variable is 2, and we have to get the value of m. So, we have to put 2 here in place of x, 2 square plus m into 2 minus 5 equal to 0. So, 2 square is 4 plus 2m minus 5 equal to 0. This is 2m minus 1 is equal to 0, plus 4 minus 5, that is minus 1. Transfer minus 1 to the right side, it will become plus 1, and m is equal to 1 upon 2, that is positive 1 upon 2. And the correct option is option C, that is 1 upon 2, positive 1 upon 2. So, here we complete the first question from the problem set 1, where we have given 8 multiple choice questions, and we explain each and every example. Second question from the problem set 2, that is, which of the following equations is quadratic? We have given 3 equations, and we have to decide which of the 3 equations are the quadratic equations. So, here we have first equation, that is x square plus 2x plus 11 is equal to 0. And now we have to decide whether it is quadratic equation or it is not the quadratic equation. As we know that equation having one variable and degree 2, equation having only one variable and degree 2 is called as quadratic equation. So, here we will check how many variables are there, how much is the degree of the given equation, and then we will decide whether it is quadratic equation or not. Before that, we have to think about the simplification. Is it possible to take any simplifications? We are unable to take any simplifications here, because we do not have similar terms there to make calculation simplifications. So, just we have to check whether it has one variable. Yes, it has one variable, and it is x. Is the degree of the equation is 2? Yes, the degree of the given equation, that is 2. So, this is quadratic equation. So, here we can write as one variable is there. As one variable is there, and degree 2, and degree 2, therefore, given equation is quadratic equation. Given equation is quadratic equation. Now, we have given second example, that is x square minus 2x plus 5 is equal to x square. Now, here we have a chance of simplification. Here we can make simplifications. See, we have x square into the right side, and you can transfer it into the left side, and then we will take subtraction of these two similar terms, and after simplification we will get that it is not the quadratic equation. Since anyone can say that this is quadratic equation, why? Because we have one variable and degree 2, but after simplification these two terms are going to eliminate, and after simplification we will get that it is not the quadratic equation. So, simplification is the most important key where we have to decide the given equation is the quadratic equation or not, and here we are able to simplification. Here we can simplify this quadratic equation. We will transfer this positive x square to the left side, and we will get x square minus 2x plus 5 minus x square equal to 0, and now here x square minus x square gets cancelled, and we have minus 2x plus 5 equal to 0. As we have one variable in the equation, but degree is not 2. We have one variable in this equation, but degree is not 2. So, it is not the quadratic equation. So, here we will write as one variable is there, as one variable is there, but degree is not 2. But the degree is not 2. Therefore, the given equation is not the quadratic equation. Given equation is not quadratic equation. And now we have third example, that is x plus 2 bracket square, that is equal to 2x square. Third example, x plus 2 bracket square, that is equal to 2x square. Now, here again we have to simplify first. Here we can make square expansion of sum of the two terms. This is x square plus 4x plus 4 is equal to 2x square. Square expansion of this bracket, x square plus 4x plus 4, that is square of the first term, sine of the middle term, product of both these terms and twice of it plus square of the second term, that is equal to 2x square. As it is, now you can transfer all these three terms to the right side, and we will get this is 2x square, positive x square is transferred to the right side, that will become negative x square minus 4x minus 4, that is equals to 0. We transfer all these three terms to the right side, so nothing is there in the left side, means we have 0 there. So we write 2x square minus x square minus 4x minus 4 is equals to 0. Now this is two similar terms we have, 2x square minus x square, that is x square minus 4x minus 4 equal to 0, and simplification is gets completed here. Now you have to decide whether it is quadratic equation or not. We have one variable in this equation and degree is 2, so it is quadratic equation. So here you can write as one variable is there, as one variable is there, and degree 2, and degree 2, given equation is quadratic equation, given equation is quadratic equation. This is all about the second question. Now, third question from the problem set 2, that is find the value of discriminant for each of the following equation. We have given the quadratic equations, and we have to find the value of discriminant for each of the quadratic equation. First equation is 2y square minus y plus 2 is equal to 0, that is the given quadratic equation, and we have to find the value of discriminant, that is value of b square minus 4ac. Value of b square minus 4ac is known as the value of discriminant, or that is called as discriminant, and it is represented by using the Greek letter delta. So, here we have to find the value of b square minus 4ac. As we have to find the value of b square minus 4ac, simply we have to know the values of a, b and c, and we have to find the values of a, b and c. It means that given quadratic equation, it should be into the standard form. That is ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0, and the given equation is into the standard form.
So directly we have to get the values of a, b and c, and then we have to find the value of discriminant, that is b square minus 4ac. So here we will write comparing with, you can write ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0, or since variable is y, so you can write ay square plus by plus c is equal to 0. We have a is equal to 2, b is equal to minus 1, and c is equal to 2. Now we have to get the value of b square minus 4ac, since we write b square minus 4ac is equal to, value of b is minus 1, square of it minus 4 into value of a is 2 into value of c is also 2. Now we have to calculate it, square of any negative number is always positive, that is 1, minus 4 to the 8, 8 to the 16, and this is 1 minus 16 is minus 15. We get the value of b square minus 4ac, and that is equal to minus 15. We have second example, we have second quadratic equation, that is 5m square minus m is equal to 0. 5m square minus m is equal to 0, and again the question is same, we have to find the value of b square minus 4ac. First check whether the given quadratic equation is into the standard form, then we will observe that constant term is not there. We have square term, we have linear term, but the constant term is not there. So we can take 0 there, that is 5m square minus m plus 0 is equal to 0, and if we do not write 0 there, it will work. Directly we will write c is equal to 0 there, but we will write the given quadratic equation into the standard form first, that is 5m square minus m plus 0 is equal to 0. Comparing with am square plus bm plus c is equal to 0. We have value of a, that is 5, we have value of b, that is minus 1, and we have value of c, that is 0. And now we will get b square minus 4ac. Value of b is minus 1, square of it minus 4 into value of a is 5 into value of c is 0. Square of any negative number is always positive, since we get 1 there, minus 4 pi is 20, and 20 into 0 is 0, and 1 minus 0 is 1. So we get b square minus 4ac is equal to 1, that is the value of discriminant, or you can write your answer into the word, therefore value of discriminant is 1. Final answer you can write here into the word, value of b square minus 4ac is 1, or value of discriminant is 1. Now we have third example. We'll write here third example. The given quadratic equation is root 5 into x square minus x minus root 5, that is equal to 0, and the given equation is in the standard form. We need not make to change there, already the given equation is into the standard form. We have to get the values of a, b and c first, and then we have to find b square minus 4ac. So here comparing with ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0, value of a is root 5, value of b is minus 1, and value of c is negative root 5. So we have to find b square minus 4ac, that is value of discriminant. So value of b is minus 1, square of it minus 4 into value of a is root 5 multiplied by negative root 5. Now here square of negative number is always positive, so we have 1, minus into minus, that is plus, we have root 5 into root 5, that is 5, and 5 multiplied by 4 is 20, and 20 plus 1 is 21. So we have b square minus 4ac is equal to 21. We can write the final answer into the word, that is value of the discriminant is 21. So this is all about the third question. Now we will solve the fourth question.